Hello and welcome to All Saints Church in St. Andrews by the Sea. We're so pleased that you could join us for this service today. This is the fifth Sunday after Easter. It's also called Rogation Sunday. It's the Sunday in which traditionally seeds are blessed and we prepare for the spring season. Even though it's been rather chilly this spring, this May, nature has its own agenda, and we're so happy to have some fresh flowers here today that Pamela has provided, reminding us of the days ahead when spring and summer will bless us. Let us pray. Eternal God, of whom the whole family in heaven and earth is named, unite us as we worship thee here with all who in all places are lifting up their hands and hearts to thee, that thy church throughout the world with the church in heaven may offer up one sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to the honor and glory of thy holy name. Amen. The Lord is risen indeed. Thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. O worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Let the whole earth stand in awe of him. The Lord is nigh unto all them that call upon him, to all that call upon him in truth. Let us prepare ourselves spiritually for this time of worship by confessing our sins. Dearly beloved, the scripture moveth us in sundry places to acknowledge and confess our manifold sins and wickedness, and that we should not dissemble nor cloak them before the face of Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, but confess them with an humble, lowly, penitent, and obedient heart, to the end that we may obtain forgiveness of the same by his infinite goodness and mercy. Wherefore I pray and beseech you, as many as are here present, to accompany me with a pure heart and humble voice unto the throne of the heavenly grace. Let us humbly confess our sins to Almighty God. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from thy ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against thy holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done, and there is no health in us. But thou, O Lord, have mercy upon us, miserable offenders. Spare thou them, O God, which confess their faults. Restore thou them that are penitent, according to thy promises declared unto mankind in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may hereafter live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of thy holy name. Amen. Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who desireth not the death of a sinner, but rather that he may turn from his wickedness and live, hath given power and commandment to his ministers to declare and pronounce to his people, being penitent, the absolution and remission of their sins. He pardoneth and absolveth all them that truly repent and unfeignedly believe his holy gospel. Wherefore we beseech him to grant us true repentance and his Holy Spirit, that those things may please him which we do at this present, and that the rest of our life hereafter may be pure and holy, so that at the last we may come to his eternal joy. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open thou our lips,
and our mouth shall show forth thy praise.
O God, make speed to save us.
O Lord, make haste to help us.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Praise ye the Lord.
The Lord's name be praised.
Let us praise God in the words of the Venite. O come, let us sing unto the Lord. Let us heartily rejoice in the strength of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving, and show ourselves glad in him with psalms. For the Lord is a great God, and a great King above all gods. In his hand are all the corners of the earth, and the strength of the hills are his also. The sea is his, and he made it, and his hands prepared the dry land. O come, let us worship and fall down, and kneel before the Lord our Maker. For he is the Lord our God, and we are the people of his pasture, and the sheep of his hand. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be,
world without end.
Amen. The psalm appointed for Rogation Sunday is Psalm 46, and we'll read the psalm responsively by verse. God is our hope and strength, a very present help in trouble.
Therefore will we not fear, though the earth be changed, and though the hills be carried into the midst of the sea.
Though the waters thereof rage and swell, and though the mountains shake at the tempest of the same.
The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge.
There is a river, the streams whereof make glad the city of God, the holy place of the tabernacle of the Most High.
God is in the midst of her. Therefore shall she not be moved. God shall help her, and that right early.
The nations make much ado, and the kingdoms are moved. But God uttereth his voice, and the earth doth melt away.
The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge.
O come hither, and behold the works of the Lord, what wonders he hath wrought upon the earth.
He maketh wars to cease in all the world. He breaketh the bow, and snappeth the spear in sunder, and burneth the chariots in the fire.
Be still then, and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations, and I will be exalted in the earth.
The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
First lesson will now be read by John.
The first lesson is written in the book of the prophet Joel, beginning at the second chapter, 21st verse. Fear not, O land, be glad and rejoice, for the Lord has done great things. Fear not, you beasts of the field, for the pastures of the wilderness are green. The tree bears its fruit, the fig tree and vine give their full yield. Be glad, O sons of Zion, and rejoice in the Lord your God. For he has given the early rain for your vindication. He has poured down for you abundant rain, the early and the latter rain, as before. The threshing floor shall be full of grain, the vat shall overflow with wine and oil. I will restore to you the years with the swarming locusts as eaten, the hopper, the destroyer, and the cutter, my great army, which I sent among you. You shall eat in plenty and be satisfied, and praise the name of the Lord your God, who has dealt wondrously with you, and my people shall never again be put to shame. You shall know that I am in the midst of Israel, and that I, the Lord, am your God, and there is none else. And my people shall never again be put to shame. Here ends the first lesson.
Today we are having three lessons from the scriptures, and the second lesson that John will now read is from the epistle of St. James. And James tells us how important it is that having heard the word of God, we put the word of God into action in our lives.
The second lesson is written in the epistle of St. James, first chapter, beginning at the 22nd verse. But be doers of the word, and not hearers only, deceiving yourselves. For if any one is a hearer of the word, and not a doer, he is like a man who observes his natural face in a mirror. For he observes himself, and goes away, and at once forgets what he looks like. But he who looks into the perfect law, the law of liberty, and perseveres, being no hearer that forgets, but a doer that acts, he shall be blessed in his doing. If anyone thinks he is religious and does not bridle his tongue but deceives his heart, this man's religion is vain. Religion that is pure and undefiled before God and the Father is this, to visit orphans and widows in their affliction and to keep oneself unstained from the world. Here ends the second lesson.
Please join now in reading the Cantate Domino. Sing unto the Lord a new song, and his praise from the end of the earth. Either go down to the sea and all that is therein, the isles and the inhabitants thereof. Let the wilderness and the cities thereof lift up their voice. Let the villages that Kedar doth inhabit. Let the inhabitants of the rocks sing. Let them shout from the top of the mountains. Let them give glory unto the Lord, and declare his praise in the islands. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Jim will now read the third lesson.
The gospel lesson is from St. John's Gospel, chapter 16, verses 23 to 33. Truly, truly, I say to you, if you ask anything of the Father, he will give it to you in my name. Hitherto you have asked nothing in my name. Ask, and you will receive, that your joy may be full. I have said this to you in figures. The hour is coming when I shall no longer speak to you in figures, but tell you plainly of the Father. In that day you will ask in my name, and I do not say to you that I shall pray the Father for you, for the Father himself loves you, because you have loved me and have believed that I came from the Father. I came from the Father and have come into the world. Again, I am leaving the world and going to the Father. His disciples said, Ah, now you are speaking plainly, not in any figure. Now we know that you know all things, and need none to question you. By this we believe that you came from God. Jesus answered them, Do you now believe? The hour is coming, indeed it has come, when you will be scattered, every man to his home, and will leave me alone. Yet I am not alone, for the Father is with me. I have said this to you, that in me you may have peace. In the world you will have tribulation. But be of good cheer, I have overcome the world. Here ends the lesson.
Please join me in reading the Jubilate Deo, Psalm 100. O be joyful in the Lord, all ye lands.
Serve the Lord with gladness, and come before his presence with a song. Be ye sure that the Lord, he is God. It is he that hath made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people, and the sheep of his pasture. O go your way into his gates with thanksgiving, and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him, and speak good of his name. For the Lord is gracious, his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endureth from generation to generation. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
And now we'll profess our Christian faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. O Lord, show thy mercy upon us.
And grant us thy salvation.
O Lord, save the Queen.
And mercifully hear us when we call upon thee.
Endue thy ministers with righteousness.
And make thy chosen people joyful.
O Lord, save thy people.
And bless thine inheritance.
Give peace in our time, O Lord.
And evermore mightily defend us.
O God, make clean our hearts within us.
And take not thy Holy Spirit from us.
The Collect for Rogation Sunday. O Lord, from whom all good things do come, grant to us, thy humble servants, that by thy holy inspiration we may think those things that be good, and by thy merciful guiding may perform the same. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Collect for peace and for grace. O God, who art the author of peace and lover of concord, in knowledge of whom standeth our eternal life, whose service is perfect freedom, defend us, thy humble servants, in all assaults of our enemies, that we, surely trusting in thy defense, may not fear the power of any adversaries, through the might of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, our heavenly Father, almighty and everlasting God, who has safely brought us to the beginning of this day, defend us in the same with thy mighty power, and grant that this day we fall into no sin, neither run into any kind of danger, but that all our doings may be ordered by thy governance to do always that is righteous in thy sight, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And now we welcome as our preacher today Reverend Kevin Borthwick, who is priest in charge of the parish of Campobello and is also an assistant here in the parish of St. Andrews and in the parish of St. David and St. Paul.
From all accounts, the first French settlers in North America put in a terrible winter in 1604 and 5 on the small island in the St. Croix River, just offshore from where many of us live today. Nothing in their experience could have prepared them for the hard winter which nature had inflicted upon them. Isolated from their families and their culture back home, struggling to get enough food and water for survival, battling a disease which they did not understand, they also had to cope with the loss of half of the 70 settlers who made up their village. When spring finally came and the ice around them melted, they left St. Croix Island and crossed the Bay of Fundy to make settlement in Port Royal. In an effort to lift their spirits and reaffirm their common bonds, after the isolation and hardship they endured, Samuel de Champlain organized a celebration of good food, theater, and merriment known as the Order of Good Cheer. Let's face it. After having gone through the last few number of weeks of this global pandemic, we could all use good cheer. With little warning, we have all found ourselves living in a whole new world from what we have ever encountered before, with little frame of reference. The necessity of social distancing and self-isolation, being unable to gather with family and friends in places of worship and other community centers, has turned our lives upside down. While we have much for which to be thankful in our part of the world, we still face much fear, anxiety, and uncertainty about the future. On this fifth Sunday after Easter, I invite you to hear the words of Jesus, which he spoke to his friends and followers. He said, "In the world you will have tribulation, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world." These were some of the last words Jesus delivered to his disciples before he was handed over to suffering and death on the cross. He knew that his suffering and death would not be in vain. In overcoming death, Jesus would break the power of evil so that it would have no lasting hold on humanity and unleash the power of God to change the world forever by bringing goodness out of evil, love out of hate, and life out of death. Only when we were on the other side of the cross could the first disciples begin to understand how their world had been changed. Only after he rose again, appeared to his disciples, walked along the road to Emmaus, explained the scriptures to them, made himself known in the breaking of the bread, would their hearts burn within them. Only after he ascended into heaven and sent the gift of the Holy Spirit upon the disciples at Pentecost would true faith be kindled and his followers come to understand what Jesus was telling them. Like the first disciples, it is only when you and I are on the other side of the cross and suffering that Easter can make sense of what Jesus is telling us. Only after we have come through a crisis that we can begin to see the bigger picture and make sense of what has happened. And it is only when we can see the hand of God reaching out to change the world for our good. It is for that reason that we are called to listen to these words of Jesus, known as the final discourse of St. John's Gospel, during the final Sundays of the Easter season, leading up to Ascension Day and the Feast of Pentecost. This fifth Sunday after Easter is called Rogation Sunday, from the Latin word meaning to ask. In his final words to his disciples, Jesus wanted to assure them that even though he was to be removed from their physical presence in this world, he would always be with them. His love would remain with them forever, in all times and in all circumstances. Jesus therefore promised his disciples that they could always come to him in prayer. Most assuredly, I say to you, whatever you ask the Father in my name, he will give you. Until now you have asked nothing in my name. Ask and you will receive, that your joy may be full. Rogation Sunday, together with the next 3 days leading up to Ascension Day this Thursday, are days of asking, a reminder that we can all claim the promise of Jesus and pray for our needs, the mission of the church in the world, and the good of God's people everywhere. The Rogation Days were instituted in the 5th century in response to terrible suffering in Europe because of a series of natural disasters which ravaged the land, the livestock and crops, causing starvation and disease among the people. Rather than feeling helpless in the face of adversity, the church called people to do something for themselves, to put their faith into action, to pray for 4 straight days for God's mercy to save and deliver them from lightning and tempest, from earthquake, fire, and flood, from plague, pestilence, and famine, from battle and murder and sudden death. Good Lord, deliver us. Words which form part of the ancient liturgy and litany of the church. Our forebearers in faith and early settlers in our nation knew their survival depended on the mercy of God to supply all their needs. As Jesus says, in the world, you will have tribulation. In other words, there will always be things natural and human-made that cause suffering. But the power of God to save and deliver is always greater. No matter how disconnected, isolated, and abandoned we may feel in the face of the changes and chances of this life, we have to trust in the presence of our crucified and risen Savior to be with us, to strengthen and help us, as he has always promised. So today, I invite you, with Christians around the world, to pray with all people everywhere, to be delivered and saved from the sufferings of this present time. Let us pray for those working to bring healing and relief to others. And let us continue to reach out to one another with God's love and acts of kindness and compassion, forgiveness and reconciliation, that we may know Christ's presence and power in our lives. For as Jesus told us, these things have I spoken to you, that in me you might have peace. In the world you will have tribulation, but be of good cheer, I have overcome the world. May God bless us as we hear and receive the seed of his word this day, that it may bear fruit in our lives. Amen.
Let us ask the God of creation to send a blessing upon us. Upon the rich earth, send a blessing, O Lord. Let the earth be fruitful and its resources be hallowed. We ask in faith.
We ask you to hear us, good Lord.
Upon human labor, send a blessing, O Lord. Prosper the work of our hands. May all find dignity and just reward in their work. Free the exploited and oppressed. We ask in faith.
We ask you to hear us, good Lord.
Upon the produce of the earth, send a blessing, O Lord. Guide us into a sustainable future and give us the will to share the fruits of the world. We ask in faith.
We ask you to hear us, good Lord.
Upon the seas and waters and their harvest, send a blessing, O Lord. Teach us to cherish the water of the earth and to conserve the seas, lakes, and rivers. We ask in faith.
We ask you to hear us, good Lord.
Upon aid agencies, send a blessing, O Lord. Where the earth is parched and the well has run dry, where war brings want and children go hungry, where the poor cry out for bread and for justice, give hands to care and heal and inspire us to be generous. We ask in faith.
We ask you to hear us, good Lord.
Upon all who work for a cure or vaccine for COVID-19, upon those who minister to the sick and the dying, and those who provide us with essential goods and services, we ask in faith.
We ask you to hear us, good Lord.
Upon all those celebrating birthdays this week, Tynan, Riley, Julie, Troy, Marianne, Lily, Bob, Diane, and Brody, we ask in faith.
We ask you to hear us, good Lord.
We ask you to hear us, good Lord, for the sake of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Thank you, Pamela, for leading us in our intercessions. And now I would invite you to pray with me a prayer of thanksgiving. We thank thee, Lord, for all thy goodness to us, for the world which thou hast made, and for strength to see thee in it, for daily revelations of thyself in nature, in art, and in the lives of your people, for the Bible through which thy word is spoken, for all other writings which reveal thy truth, for the task to which you call us. But above all, we thank thee for thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, through whom we see thee, who art our Father. May his Spirit dwell within us, making us to serve thee with gladness all the days of our life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, who has given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications unto thee, and has promised that when two or three are gathered together in thy name, thou wilt grant their requests. Fulfill now, O Lord, the desires and petitions of thy servants as may be most expedient for them, granting us in this world knowledge of thy truth, and in the world to come, life everlasting. Amen. Please join me in the grace. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Ghost be with us all evermore. Amen. Thank you for joining us today by television and by the internet. We look forward to the day when we can worship together once again in this beautiful church. Next Sunday, our preacher will be Bob Cheatley. Look forward to seeing you then.